So next will be Marcel Nijenhof, a well-known face at the Tito's conference. And this will be about Nagios and how to monitor several systems. And some of you might know NRPE for this, but it's for that service you have to transmit data for every service on every machine. And CheckMK does this for all the services on a machine at once. And Marcel will tell something to us about that.
Yeah, this is mainly one experience what I had in a new environment. But let's start with the start. And that's given the fact, where do we want to spend our time? Working on our monitor systems or doing something we like? And I would say, spend as less time as possible on your monitoring system. But it's still important. A short introduction of the talk. I will tell something about myself, then I will talk about my vision about monitoring, a little bit about Nagios, and then I will go to the main topic, CheckMK. I will say something about monitoring and Nagios to give a starting point. Otherwise, yeah, you can't discuss what CheckMK does. Then I will go in on the results I had. Actually, I had to replace a Nagios configuration. And they already decided they liked the CheckMK setup, and I didn't know anything about it. I never heard it on conferences, and it actually worked quite well. So that's the reason why I think it's a good topic here. Well, something about myself. I do a lot of things, but the two important things is, I'm also board member of the ENLUG, and there will be a conference on the 8th of November. And tomorrow I will do some LPE exams. So you are invited for that as well. Then monitoring. Well, monitoring. We want alarms. But you have to know how to do that, and you have to define the problem, otherwise it won't work. I think there are three layers in a monitoring system. First of all, you have to observe things. You have to see what is actually going on your system. Then you have to filter. Is something actually an alarm? Is something okay? So that's the filtering part. And then, you have to do something with your observations. So you have to show the results. So you are doing something like reporting. And you will see those three parts back, and I will use this way of dividing things to show where CheckMK is. Then you have different types of monitoring. And this is actually one of the important things. I will make a division between the monitoring of services. Is a web page available? Am I able to connect to a mail server? And is the system running okay? The element monitoring. And those two are really different, and especially Nagios is very good for service monitoring, and they use that model to try to monitor the element. So I don't think that's working that well. So that's the reason why I present this, that there is a difference, and that maybe we should do things different for elements. Well, something about Nagios. It's a platform-independent way of monitoring your systems. You have plugins to observe. Well, basically, the plugins already filter, because the result of the plugin is either it's an alarm or not. It's not really gathering the information. It's just plainly saying, it didn't work, so it's an alarm. The central server schedules all those checks, so that's okay. Yeah, and it filters something, but actually just gives the result directly back. So there's no real filtering in the results you get. It's either okay or not okay. And the plugin already tells that. So it's not the filtering, it's not done central, but it's done in the check. well, you have to report in the web page. And okay, well, you can use plugins to send alarms, to create SMSs, to create mail. So that's the way the reporting is done. What about the configuration? Well, there are lots and lots of extra plugins to maintain your Nagios configuration. And most of them are causing a lot of work without, well, a lot of help, because it's if you have to configure all those checks manually, and, well, think about that 1,000 checks, it's a lot of work to do that in a web framework. Let's see one moment how the NRPA setup is for checking one event. You get this picture where a plugin is used, the plugin for NRPA, but you can also use the check by SSH just to get a small script to run on the server and get a result. What's all involved? Well, you have the plugin on your central Nagios server. Then you have the connection to your NRPA daemon on the other side. On that side, well, probably your NRPA daemon doesn't run as root, so you have some pseudo configuration there. You certainly have configuration for NRPA, which tells which checks are allowed within NRPA. So that are already two configuration files. Then you have to maintain your local plugins on that server, and that's for one check. What if I want to do 50 checks on that server? I will set up 50 connections to that server. I have about 100 lines of configuration. For each check, I do have the configuration and maybe the pseudo rules. Well, probably some of the checks are similar, so maybe a little bit less, but well, there's a lot of lines there. So it's hard to maintain, and 50 times a connection, well, doing that from one server and checking 100 servers is 5,000 connections is a lot. But the biggest problem is the configuration is mainly local. There's a lot of local configuration, and you have to maintain both sides. You have to do some configuration on the server side, telling the Nagios server to do the check, having configuration on the client side, where what is allowed, what NRPA is allowed to do. So this is a double administration, and it's hard to maintain. And it would be a lot nicer if this site has a smart client. And actually, that is the part of CheckMK which I like. There is a smart client on that site. So let's go to CheckMK. It's a regular add-on on Nagios, so it's a similar plugin as NRP. There's nothing different from Nagios for CheckMK as for NRP. It's a regular plugin you can call, and it will give you one result back. Yes, I have run, or no, I haven't run, but it has a side effect. The side effect is that it will do a lot of other checks as well, and it will give the results of those checks back as passive checks. So it's, in one side, it's just a regular plugin. Well, of course, I told that there is a lot of there's a lot of extra checks, and it needs configuration for those checks. So it has its own configuration language in which you tell CheckMK which checks to perform. And, well, that configuration language is a lot easier for a lot of cases than the Nagios configuration language. And the biggest part of it is because it actually knows the status of the element you are monitoring, it can create a lot of checks automatically. And that helps a lot. And then there is a new web content. I will show the picture, but it's not really part of the presentation. It's just here. It's a modern front end with a lot of windows you can manipulate and a lot of the new web stuff in it. But well, it's not the part where I did most of the work. It's even usable for some part of the configurations. But that's not the part I'm going to talk about. So this is really the big picture. You have two parts in the configuration. You have, of course, you have your standard Nagios setup. And nothing is changed of it. Nagios will call CheckMK. CheckMK will make a call to the host and to the host agent on that host. That host agent will do a lot of checks. Not actually checks, it will gather information. How full are the disks? How many network connections are open? It won't generate any alarms. It's just gathering information. And that information is sent back to CheckMK. CheckMK will check that information it gets and decides if that information is above thresholds, which is in the CheckMK configuration. It also will make sure that measurements are stored in RDD graphs, so that you have an overview of really what is the status of your server. So that will give you also a lot of information. And then it will send the results of those filter actions back to Nagios. So you get really a lot of alarms just by running this. Well, you still need to configure what it checks over here. But fortunately, a lot of that is done automatically. CheckMK is really smart. The first time you see it sees a server and you say, please make a list of that server and configure all sensible checks automatically, it will do that. And that helps you, really helps you. For instance, well, we all want to monitor how full the disks are. Well, we don't make tests for that with CheckMK. CheckMK knows that we want to do that. So the only thing you do is make an inventory of the server, and your disk checks are there. But then again, I want different alarm levels. It could, you can change it. But it has also some smart guesses about that. It will decide, this is a small disk. I need a larger pool in reserve, so my alarm level is lower than for big disks. If you have special cases, you have to override it. But in general, most of the defaults are really good. So most of the checks are based on what is on the server. And this really helps. It's not about only about how full are the disks, but also the mirroring of disks is checked automatically. The network status is checked automatically. And really a lot of those counters which are in your OS are checked. Just running an inventory on a normal server will give you about 50 checks, and you haven't done anything at that moment. And that is really something which helps you. So that's about how CheckMK work. Then we have that metrically part over here, that agent. There are really two agents there. CheckMK also knows a lot about SNMP, so you could connect to an SNMP daemon and do lots of these checks on network equipment over SNMP. That's the first method. The second method is running a script CheckMK agent on the Linux system. It's a regular shell script, and it really does really simple things. Running df, running ps, and putting the output in one file, separating them by recognizable tags so that it knows, well, this is the list of processes. And actually, it's smaller than PS, bigger than, and then you see the PS list. And the same it does for netstat, ifconfig, all those commands you give, it will run those commands, put the output in the file, and send it to the central server. And as said, it's the output of the commands. It's not the checks. Given the fact that the disk is 95% full or 50% full, is for the check MK agent not an alarm. The alarm is done on the central component, the check MK component, which is running on your Nagios server. And of course, we have a lot of standard checks, but your application, your dedicated application is not there. So it has to be extensible. And because it's basically is just a shell script, it's extensible. So, well, the information you already get is over here. I already told you. And it includes indeed information about certain RAID hardware, the IPMI parameters, and those kinds of things. And even standard applications like NTP are reported. Then we go to how do we extend this? Well, there are three ways to do that. And one of them, fortunately, is MRPA. If you don't want to think an MRPA was running on this system, just add that check to the MRPA config file, and it will run that check and incorporate the results in CheckMK. So that's quite easy. The second way is the local check method. The local checks is a little extension to the standard Nagios plugins. The standard Nagios plugins use the return code of the script to detect if it's a failure or not. And the problem of that is that you only can output a single line. Local scripts are allowed to give more than one result. But you have to put the result line on you put the result on the first line. So there's a number, the line is starting with a number, and that's the result code. So instead of using the exit code, place the number as first element in the line and it works. That are the two easy way to get an extra check in CheckMK. Then there's the third one, the plugin method. And the plugin method is actually the native one. You will add a new tag to the output, generate output, not alarms, and that output has to be parsed on the server and checked if it contains alarms. That also means that you need a plugin on the server because it needs to parse that output and decides if that has an alarm. The advantage of using the last method is, of course, that the alarms are generated on the server and you don't need any local config. So that's the good point of this. So the last method is preferred, but it also means adding a plugin to the central CheckMK program. And that's a little bit harder. So the first two methods, well, we know them. The last one is new and is a little bit harder. And then it also comes with one of the standard plugins it comes with it is a log file filter. This is really useful because trying to filter log files with Nagios, well, you get the alarm. The next time the script runs, it sees no errors. So it decides that the script didn't find any errors. It clears the error in your Nagios. And, well, there was 5 minutes an alarm that there was a message in the log file. And now it's gone. That is not what I want. I intercept the log message and I want to keep it. So I want to keep the state. And the LogWatch plugin of CheckMK does that. It's one of the standard plugins. You just give him the configuration there. And unfortunately, this is configuration which is local to the client you want to monitor. So this is really one of the things where local configuration is needed, which is, well, the downside of this one. If it finds a regular expression which you have given for a certain file, it will send the result to the central server. And on the server side, you have the viewer for those log files, and there's entries it found. And you have to acknowledge it on the server side. Yes, I have seen this message. Yes, I have taken measures to prevent it. And please go on with your work. Well, in the current situation, it has no multi-line support. And that's one of the things which I am missing. Because basically, some events I'm not interested if those happen one time. But if I see a lot of those messages, well, that would be very interesting. And that would be one of my wishes, because actually that would be useful to filter Apache logs for failures of pages. So if you see a trace from one client trying to go through all those URLs with standard scripts, which you haven't installed, well, if you see one, well, can be that it's just one case. If you see hundreds of them, you know somebody's probing my server. And that is something I want to know. So creating a similar one for doing these kind of detections might be useful. On the other side, maybe that should be done by an EDS anyway. So that's the client side. This is the agent running, doing this work. So. And I think this is really useful. Then we have the checkmk script of the checkmk program running on the central NACHER server. It really does a lot of more. Checkmk is not just a simple shell script. This is a lot of Python code which implements all those details. It does auto inventory, meaning if you give it some output of either SNMP, which it can do itself, or checkmk agent, then it will check what is actually the hardware components on that server, what is actually, how's that server configured, what's there, and create automatically the checks it needs to do. Then it will look at the configuration, and you have to put some configuration there. You have to tell it which host to check. For host, you put there in the configuration, it will do the auto configuration and do the extra checks you specify. So actually, you have to specify which processes to check, because it sees the processes, but it doesn't know which are running short and which are running long and which should be guarded and which not. So one of the things you will tell, please monitor those processes. And in the configuration is also the option to put extra legacy checks. So yeah, you still need to do a lot of configuration, but it's all central. And most of the things you don't need to do. I don't have to make checks for disk full and all those things which are standard on all servers. Then in regular use, NACHER will call checkmk. Checkmk will either run an SNMP query or a checkmk agent remotely. It will parse the results, create alarms, and send the counters to RDD, so that those are all stored as well. So you will see your checks, you will see your alarms, and at the end, you can see what was the result over a month, how busy was my server. So all those kinds of things are stored. There's a new configuration language for checkmk, of course, because it's different of NACHER. And it's a completely tag-based language. What you do is actually you add a host to the host list of servers to check, and then you add some tags. For instance, LAMP. This is a standard LAMP server. Please do a check for that. Then you have to configure which checks to do, of course. So I have to add checks for that tag as well. I can use those same tags to add that server to a certain host or service group. There is some syntax to tell CheckMK, this is a cluster, please do some cluster checks on it. And then, of course, I can add the legacy checks also on this side, so that I can run regular NACHIOS commands on the server. It's a quite simple language, which you can write, and then your complete NACHIOS configuration will be configured and generated. So let's look to the example of a simple LAMP server. I add the tag LAMP to a server. So www tag LAMP added. That's all I have to specify to monitor that server. Then, of course, I have to do my checks on those servers. Well, there need to be two processes which are running. Those two. The web server has to be running, and the MySQL daemon has to be running. And maybe I want to do a server-side check as well, if I can reach the index HTML on that server. That's basically what I want to check. So I have written now 4 lines of configuration. And that server is now monitored. At this moment, if I run the inventory on that server, it will generate all the checks. This includes those 3, which I have specified, and all the others as well. Well, how many checks will there run on this server? How many alarms? I don't know. I will see as soon as I run. But one cache could be 42. Why not? No, actually, probably this is too less. There are really going a lot of checks to be done on this server. Is the memory full? Is the NTP daemon giving a correct timing? One of the things we find is that NTP is running badly, and that there is an offset of more than 200 milliseconds on lots of systems. This check is done automatically. Nobody thought about checking the settings of NTP before we install this. Yeah, normally you don't expect that, but well, we have slow lines, can happen. So we are outside of their normal scope. Lots of network settings, disk and file system, all are checked, and it's really powerful because I had 3 lines of code, 42 checks. That makes it easy to do a lot of checking. Are there downsides? Yeah, there are. All checks are run at once. If you have one important check, you want to run once a minute. And one check which is expensive, which takes 2 minutes to compute. And you want to run that only once an hour. Well, this is not going to work with CheckMK. Because as soon as you fire the script, everything is run at once. So it's not one check once a minute and one once an hour. So that's a little bit of a disadvantage. The result set you get sent back is really big. The biggest part is the listing of PS. PS on a busy server, well, can be 10K of results. So you end up with 20 kilobytes of results sending back. Well, is this a problem? Not really, unless you are trying to run this over lines of 460 kilobits. So yeah, we used gzip to compress the results on some systems which are behind slow lines. Then there's no encryption. The CheckMK agent is integrated in Xenu Day, and in that way it's run, and well, you use host allow to make sure that only the NACHIOS server is allowed to execute this. And this is really a downside. But then again, in the documentation of CheckMK is also the remark, if you don't like it, start the script over SSH. And basically that's what we did. Well, I started with a situation where we used Nagios and Nagios SQL to configure it. And now we have replaced this with CheckMK. And actually, I think it works. So at the moment, we are monitoring 100 hosts with it. And it was quite easy to configure them, because you only have to configure the specific things you want to monitor. And lots of the standard checks, you don't configure. Those are done automatically. So that really helps. One of the results we found was that instead of 1,500 checks on servers, we did 7,000, which is a lot more. And most of them were those basic checks, which we didn't configure at all. So, yeah. Is that good? Well, yeah. We found things which we didn't think about. Well, we found broken disks in RAID arrays. Well, bad. Or configuration we had before was not complete, was not working perfectly, was tagged to one platform and the other platforms were added, but not really good. So that shouldn't have happened. We found multipath failures. Also, maybe that check should be included in the other configuration, but it wasn't. Nowhere. The other things we found were things like duplex mismatching on network. Well, nobody thought about checking that. And now it's done automatically. And this one is really the one which I think which shows that it really works. So, yeah. We know our configuration was not perfect. We knew we needed to replace it. And, well, this worked out for us. Well, then I come to a conclusion. I have the link to CheckMK, which worked out for us. And I've put the link to the CheckMK site on it. And actually, there is really, really a lot of documentation on that one. If you decide to start with it, look at the documentation, because it's really good. And for the rest, well, as always, there is time for questions. And the passive checks don't cost any traffic. Normally, you would probably generate 10 checks. If I would do all those checks, I would make a session to that server 50 times. Even creating those 50 sessions is a lot of traffic. And now, creating that output of 20 kilobytes, I do it once in 5 minutes. It's not a lot of traffic. Well, we're doing this at this moment once every 5 minutes. So the traffic is 20 kilobytes every 5 minutes. And then I have about 10 servers which are behind slow lines. And I even compress the file to 5 kilobytes. So there I have an overhead of 5 kilobytes every 5 minutes. That's nothing. Probably the setup of the SSH session is more expensive than that 5 kilobytes. I have done measurements because I was really afraid for those slow connections. And it turned out, well, 100 bytes or something less than that on the average, I believe.
I think the gain here is that it's one package instead of like 10, 15. And that if you send 10, 15 times the same thing, in those 5 minutes, rather than one package, and the one package wins in most cases. It's better in most cases, less load, both on the line and on the receiving end.
Yeah, you might be right here, but if you run all once, it's possible that the server
will
handle more load.
On the servers, on the local.
The monitor system will make sure that it can handle the load and won't schedule those at the same time. It's not a contract which actually runs them at 12 o'clock and 5 minutes over 12. Nagios schedules those checks and will make sure that it divides those checks over the period it has.
But I think you mean on the monitoring system that it might have to do all the checks at once. But you still have, like, on such a monitoring system, you'll probably have 50 machines which you get separated over 5 minutes anyway. So you just get all the checks of one machine at once. So I think it's...
My personal opinion is that it's not the same thing. I mean, if you run 15 commands at once, it's not the same thing as running 15 commands along the 5 minutes.
Yes.
Secondly, if you use the archiver, the results, you need to make sure probably that you have the archiver installed on the machine and that uses some CPU. Yeah, it's not the big amount of data.
Well. Nagios will make sure that that runs all nicely, so not nice, but that will divide all those checks over time. So the only problem we had on the server is running 7,000 checks. Most of them have RDD graphs attached to them. Actually, the only problem we saw was the I/O of RDD. It couldn't handle the I/O from that amount of graphs. And we added an extra cache to the hardware cache to the create array, and after that it ran fine. But without that, that was the only problem.
Did you ever have a problem with tests hanging, not producing results? So usually you run all the tests separately, and then maybe one will fail. But now if it hangs, then you don't get anything from the server.
We had some cases where then I have to do a careful look to it, but most of those checks will be started through an external programma WaitMax, and it will wait 2 seconds, and after that it will shoot down that test to make sure that that doesn't happen.
Okay.
But if you write your own plugins, you have to take care for that.
Yeah, or they might take longer than 2 seconds.
Yeah, in that case you have to give it a little bit longer time, but there are actually cases where that can happen, and there are measures in the script to prevent that. So that is taken care for. Yeah, maybe we could discuss it afterwards. Are there other people at the moment with questions? And I would say that for everyone else, it's time for lunch.
Well, in 5 minutes, the next lecture or lunch. You can ask them one more question.
Yeah. Well, the passive checks are completely different. It's a different system. And yeah, you could use legacy checks and run those checks again, either by check by SSH or check by NAPI, and have your active checks back. Yeah, it's an option. If you decide for a certain check I want to do it always, it's not a problem.
So you say, for example, the checks you want to run more often or the checks you want to run less often, you can just use MRP.
Yeah, that's an option. So that's completely not a problem. And if you use the legacy syntax, the legacy check syntax in NAPI, or in CheckMK, you can still use the new configuration language and generate your Nagios config, which is one of the nice features, because using tags to separate your servers really works. It helps you keeping a short configuration.